I'm Rick Love for the 2013 Sonoma International Film Festival Filmmaker Interview Series here on SVTV 27. And I have in the studio with us the director Trent Anderson of the short Where Is God and narrator Mike Knott. So, gentlemen, welcome back.
Good to see you again.
You were here last year with a film called Buskers that we talked about in this very room.
Yep.
And this year's project is called Where Is God? Very provocative title. So why don't you tell us a little bit about your film?
Okay, well, this is something, I'm not a very religious person. I'm, I guess, an agnostic, if I'm anything. But years ago, I traveled all over the world, India and everywhere, searching and meditating and doing all these different things. And about 6 or 7 years ago, 5 years ago, I'm not sure how long ago it was, I woke up one morning and this question came in my mind, where is God? And so I mentioned it to Mike and he said, oh, that's great, let's do it. So we went out on the streets of the Bay Area, we went to San Francisco, we went to Sausalito, Berkeley, Santa Rosa, went all over and just set up a camera and asked people to come by and would they answer a question. And I think we gave them a dollar a piece or something like that, and they signed a model release. And we asked them the question, and we got a vast array of answers, you know, everything from something very religious to atheist to humorous to scientific. I don't know. What do you think?
You know, it's intriguing. It's, for one thing, when you say, where is God, God's a loaded word. People will say, you know, are you religious? They'll say, no, I'm very spiritual. Mm-hmm. And I think that when you have the chance to talk to people about that and give, kind of hit them right between the eyes, where is God? And then leave it alone, run with them. In no way do we want to influence anybody's opinions or their responses. We literally cataloged them and then put them together in groupings so that it kind of made sense. The movie is amusing because it's just people answering a vital question. So while people might be a part of a religious construct or might be atheist, or wandering in between faith traditions, it's the answers are fun. The question's intriguing. Even people that, if they have great faith and they're just dying to tell you all about their beliefs, or they're completely put off, and then they'll kind of re-enter. I mean, it's so provocative, like you said. I mean, it really.
Well, we got one of the best answers, I think, was this guy, I don't know where he was from, maybe India or the Middle East somewhere, and he said, oh, God is everywhere. God's in the pavement. God's in the cheeseburger. And, and another guy, he's right behind you. And, you know, we got all kinds, as Michael says, we got just a lot of different categories. So we categorized it in editing so that it, I think it made sense. But.
Mm-hmm. Well, the interesting thing about the question is it's not who is God, which is more of a theological question. And it's not, does God exist, which is kind of challenging, but it's, where is God? So it really is open to physical geography and places, but it's the idea of the question is, first of all, it presupposes that God exists. So that's one thing. And you can, that is a point of challenge for some people right away. But it presupposes that God exists, and it says that God is present. Both of those two things. Did you think about that when you thought about framing the question?
I didn't. It just, the question just came to my mind. And as I said, I guess personally I'm more of an agnostic, which to me means that I don't think that this world that we live in, it's too magnificent, it's too amazing. Just the fact that we can talk to each other, you know, bugs, mosquitoes, animals, dogs, people, you know, clouds, whatever, didn't just happen by accident. It couldn't have just, how did it happen? Well, people that don't believe in God say, well, it just happened. Well, but how? I don't know. So to me, that's absurd. But on the other hand, then it means that there must have been some kind of a creator, an intelligent being that created all of this. But if there is, and I think there probably is something like that, that it would be an insult to say that he's sitting up there on a throne and going to spank you if you eat meat on Friday. Well, why didn't he just make it impossible for you to eat meat on Friday? And then he wouldn't have been unhappy about it. You know, so that's my theory. And I don't know whether that answers your question. But
no, I think it does. And the other thing that you come across is a lot of people put words in God's mouth. And that's something that I'm sure comes across and is responsible for most of the strife and war and problems that we have had
I agree. That's
in the history of the world.
That's it, religion.
Yeah,
Onward Christian soldiers marching mm-hmm. off to war, you know. I mean, that's one of the big problems we have, is that all these religions are fighting with each other over a lot of silly, you know, your wife can't go outside without this hood over her head. I mean,
mm-hmm. Well, you know, you're talking about, again, there's religion and then there's spirituality. All the people that were the foundation of the spiritual disciplines were in connection with their feelings and with some sort of essence. Mm-hmm. And then all of a sudden it started being a bunch of rules and regulations, started looking like a training manual from the CHP or something.
Mm-hmm.
The essential part of it that I find, I guess, kind of intriguing is that even those that say they don't want to think about it, that's really because they don't want to, and that's strong. I want to talk about it, that's strong. What I found so amazing, and what I think even the audience will say, they're going to sit there saying, all right, this is going to be a religious movie, or weren't I going to say good things about my belief system?
Mm-hmm.
So everybody has a buy-in. So that's what was so cool about the question. We can, it could be discussed and obviously battled over for years.
And has been.
Yeah.
I'm sure.
One of the greatest things I ever did hear once from a fellow that was at a religious convention, he was from the Middle East, but he was referring to all religions, and he says, you know, the world's religions seem to be imploding upon the weight of their own egos.
Mm-hmm.
And that, for me, is where, from a religious point of view, a lot of strife comes from. And yet, our spiritual beliefs and what we want to believe in and what gives us joy and happiness, hey, that's why you get up in the morning.
Mm-hmm.
That never went away.
Right. A heady topic, indeed. The film is Where Is God? Thank you very much to director Trent Anderson and narrator of the film, Mike Knott, for coming in and talking to us on SVTV 27's 2013 Sonoma International Film Festival Filmmaker Interview Series.